Good morning, dear students. I am Dr. Savita Tirme, and we are studying the subject Economic Zoology and Chapter 11, Model Animal in Pharmaceutical Industry. Okay, so what do you mean by model animal, or what do you mean by the use of model animal in the pharmaceutical industry? Any animal, or you can say if any drug is going to discover, that drug is need to be tested on some animal. Right, if the drug is discovered or drug is proposed to be discovered for the human being, so for the discovery, or you can say for the authentication of that particular drug, it is need to be tested on the similar kind of animal or the animal which bears a similar property or characteristic, certain characteristic like the human. So such an animal is said to be model animal. And not even, you cannot say that the why the drugs cannot be tested on the human. No, drugs, they directly cannot tested on the human. They need to be validated prior before testing on the human being, and it is validated on the performing experiments on the model organism. So model animals in the pharmaceutical industry, the in pharmaceutical industry conduct or supports approximately 1/3 of the animal research. They performs the research directly on the animals. They even frame or discover any kind of a drug, and that is tested on the animal body and study what kind of symptoms or effects are produced on the animal body. Right, on the basis of that, these animals were maintained, reared in the animal husbandry, or you can say in the animal rearing house, these animals are reared, and then whenever required, different developmental stages of such animals, they are easily available and related research can be performed. Relative effect of a particular drug at a particular stage of development can be studied in such a industries. So some of this is basic research, and that seeks to examine normal biological processes and the nature of diseases. And the way medicines are currently produced in terms of 8 stages, whatever medicines we are getting in the market, or whatever medicines are there in the market, all these medicines are undergone through 8 different stages of development, we can say. So what these 8 stages are there? So discovery and selection of a compounds that could be effective medicine. First of all, what they need to do, they need to discover a particular compound, say active compound of a medicine, right? So that active compound is need to be discovered first. Once it is discovered, then it is properly selected, right? And this discovery and selection of the active compound is the stage 1 and stage 2. So if you could not discover, what you will select, what you will characterize, what you will further study, you cannot do that, right? So discovery and selection of a compound is important, and that is first stage and second stage. Then characterization of a promising candidate medicine is stage 3 and stage 4. So here in this case, once the drug is discovered and it has been selected, then what kind of properties that particular chemical compound shows, right? So for what it can be used, how it can be used. So such a characterization of that promising candidate medicine, a single particular molecules, is need to be studied. So stage 3 and stage 4 is that, that is characterization of a particular candidate medicine. And then selection, selecting candidate medicine and ensuring their safety. Whatever candidate medicine has been characterized already now in previous stage, that is stage 3 and stage 4. Now selection of that candidate medicine and ensuring their safety. No doubt, I am saying that the candidate medicine or a particular medicine is useful for this, it is useful for that, and it has certain kind of a properties. Okay, fine. But does it shows any kind of adverse effect on the animal body, or if whether it is safe in a little bit more dose, or does it cause any kind of adverse effect on the animal body, that need to be studied earlier. So this is the stage 5, where in which the selecting candidate medicine and ensuring their safety is there. Then the last stage is clinical studies on the human. That is stage 6 and stage 8. Once the medicine is discovered, it has been characterized, even also ensuring its safety, and once it is found to be safe to be tested on the human, then and then only it is further used to test on the human. So clinical studies on the human is there, that is stage 6 to stage 8, and also research carried out to support the medicines once it has been marked, right? So for further stages, like for the testing of the candidate medicine and property testing, model animals, they are used. Yes, now what is the model animal? A laboratory animal useful for medical research because it has a specific characteristic that resembles a human disease or disorder. Right? What is it? A laboratory animal useful for medical research because it has a specific characteristics that resemble a human disease or disorder. So if the organism is sharing some human property or sharing some properties that are similar with the human being, some diseases or disorders that are again similar with the human being, then such an animal can be selected as a model animal for pharmaceutical testing. So pharmaceutical companies have long used model organism both in preclinical studies as well as for the toxicity testing. Yes. Now, beyond simply testing drugs in animals to ascertain their safety, researchers are increasingly seeking animal models not only of the specific disease but also of the particular pathway being targeted. Right. So, for what the model animals they are used? Model animals they are used for testing the drug, for testing the drug safety, as well as for testing a particular pathway, effect of a drug on a particular pathway, metabolic pathway, like that. Model animals they are used in the laboratory, and if the testing on such a model animal is successful, then and then only the said drug can be tested on a human being. Let's see the process of discovery and development of a medicine through the chart which we have studied in this slide, stages 1 to 8. Right. Now, discovery and selection of the potential new medicine is stage 1 and stage 2. In that, target identification, target drug, or you can say molecule, is identified, and identification of a possible medicine is there. Then the characterization of a promising candidate medicine, stage 3 and stage 4. So that lead identification and leads optimization of a particular medicine. And ensuring the safety of the selected candidate. So that includes the selection of a particular candidate medicine, that is stage 5. And selecting candidate medicine is there, is what the particular medicine is selected for the study, which are again performed on the model animals, and clinical studies on the human. Generally, in for the clinical studies on the human, no model organism is being used, but for the previous testing, model organisms they are used for the drugs optimization as well as safety measures. And in the clinical studies on the human, stage 6, in which the concept testing is there, what proportion of the drug is taken and how the doses will be given to human, that is tested prior. In stage 7, development of the launch is there, and 8, launch phase. How the drugs can be delivered, whether it is delivered in the form of a capsule, tablets, or through the salines, through the injections, that is intravenous. What kind of a launch method we need to opt. So, on the basis of property or characterization of that medicine, whether it is water soluble or whether it is fat soluble, again on the basis of that, the launch methods are decided, and launch phases, how it can be given, in how many doses it can be given, that is decided prior. Right. So, these are the overall processes of drug discovery and development of a particular medicine. Now, This includes the use of animal models. This drug testing includes the use of animal models, including transgenic animals, right? Genetically modified animals, GMOs, we call them as in GMOs. So these GMOs can be used for drug testing. And the use of a non-human primates, like, okay, what do you mean by non-human primates? Non-human primates are said to be the animal which are closely relatives of the human, right? Just like a gorilla, chimpanzee is there, even the lorius is there. Number of such non-human primate animals are there, right? Monkeys are there. They are said to be non-human primates. So they are close relative of a human, and they can be used as a testing organism or the model organism for testing a particular drug. Now, animal models uses animal models. Animal model uses animal models, including transgenic animals, to reflect the human diseases. Now, here, if they use a non-human primate, as they are having overall body physiology, body morphology, as well as the body biochemistry similar to the human. So, the diseases occur in the human also found to be similarly observed in these primates. So, whatever kind of a medicine is given, that might be showing a relatively close response in the non-human primate. So, hence they can be selected. And to obtain the best scientific and predictive information about the effect and safety of its a new pharmaceutical product prior to testing it on the people. So these model animals are selected. Model animals are preferred for testing the particular drug, right? If the particular drug is having some kind of a adverse effect on the body physiology or body metabolism, then that can be prevented, right? So, that particular drug should be modified further, and then only it is tested on the model animals, right? And if a particular drug, say, Y drug, is having no adverse effect on the body physiology or growth of a model organism, then that drugs, after several testing on the model animal, it can be tested on the human, okay? Unless and until it is found to be safe to be tested on the human. So, non-human primates are used to evaluate certain drugs for efficacy and safety prior to testing it in the human or and to model certain human diseases. Yes, why this is so? Because the non-human primates like lorries, monkeys, okay, lemur, chimpanzee, gorilla, all these are the close primate, means close member of the human, having overall physiology, morphology, biochemistry is similar to the human. Maximum pathways, they are also found to be similar in them. So, if a particular drug is tested on them, that gives a better result. And if a particular disease is treated with a new drug, that can give a better result. And that, on the basis of result obtained or the estimated result, one can refer that drug to be tested on the human, right? So such a type of testing can be done, can be performed on the model organism, and then the drugs can be tested. If found to be safe to be tested on the human, then and then only it is tested on the human. Now, okay, most of the animals used by the pharmaceutical industry are involved in stage 3 and stage 4. What is stage 3 and stage 4? Stage 3 and stage 4 is a characterization of a particular medicine, characterization of a promising medicine candidate, right? So that, okay, yes. Yes, most of the animals used by the pharmaceutical industry are involved in stage 3 and stage 4, where the characterization of a particular medicine is there, right? And up to 80% of the total animals, they are used for testing in stage 3 and stage 4. Okay, some techniques such as a method for administering a medicine and measuring the level in the blood are generic for all type of research and testing. Okay, some testing such as methods for administering a particular medicine, how the medicine is to be introduced into the body of a model organism. That is a method of administering a medicine. It's almost common for all the generic medicine or for all type of medicine. Either it can be given intravenously, either it can be given through the saline, or either it can be given orally. Like this, some methods which are common, method of administering a medicine are common, and measuring the level in the blood are also generic for all type of testing research as well as for the candidate medicines. For example, one model may be used to identify targets for compounds to treat acute tissue damage after a stroke. What is the example? One model may be used to identify targets for compounds, particular target for compounds to treat acute tissue damage after a stroke, whereas another may seek to find targets relevant to long-term recovery from the stroke. So these are the two main factors which need to be tested, and these are the generic one. What is that? Identifying a target for the compound. Okay, here is identifying a target for the compound to be tested for the stroke, and how long the effect lasts once the medicine is given. Whether the medicine is effective for 4 hours, 10 hours, 15 hours, what is the longevity of the medicine in the body of a particular animal is need to be tested. And these are these two things, that is identification of a target cells or target organ is again common, generic to all, as well as longevity, that is long-term existence or relief with the help of a particular drug, is again standard one. Right. So these two studies, these two parameters are again remain common for all. Then they are generally used either to determine if a gene is important as a target, that is called as a target validation, or once its importance is known as a much more specific animal model of a disease. Right. Like this, number of things are there in the pharmaceutical industries. Alright, at the subsequent stages, means stage 4, 5, we have seen stage 3 and 4. So, at the subsequent stages, toxicity tests on the animals are undertaken to meet the requirement of regulators. What? Toxicity tests on the animals are undertaken to meet the requirement of the regulators that a potential medicine demonstrate an acceptable balance of safety and efficacy. Okay, so toxicity test on the animals, for what it has been undertaken? It is undertaken for characterization, it is undertaken for optimization, it is undertaken for longevity testing, even it is also undertaken for the standardization of the candidate medicine. So these things are need to be tested with the safety. Even toxicity studies account for between 5 and 20% of animal used by the pharmaceutical industry. That means for the toxicity testing, if a particular drug is how much it is toxic, it is need to be tested. And for such a testing, 5 to 20% of the animals are used. Now, on what basis this 5 to 20% of the animals are decided? On the basis of what? Say 100 animals are required for testing a particular drug. So out of that 100 animals, 5 to 20% animals were selected for the toxicity testing. Not out of entire animal rearing house. It is not like that. It is for the predefined group, 5 to 20% of the animals are used for the pharmaceutical industries. Now in 2003, Pharmacological Safety and Efficacy Evaluation constituted 10% of the total number of animal produced in the Great Britain, right? For toxicity study, 5 to 20% animals were used. And for the safety study and efficacy evaluation, how much the drug is effective, how longer or how much it is safe to use on the human. So, total 10% animal of 10% animals were used, right? So, animal tests at this stage are much more uniform compared to the experiments carried out in drug discovery, and they need to be conducted in a format that is accepted worldwide, right? So, this is again a generalized statement. The testing need to be conducted in a format that is accepted worldwide. So, World Health Organization has put forth certain standard procedures for drug testing on the animals, model animals, and all these drugs, then they need to be tested prior testing on the, even on the human. So, they need to be tested on the animals. Before that, these drugs need to be characterized. What would be the possible characteristic? What would be the possible effect of these drugs? What would be the possible toxicity may produced by the drug? So, such a kind of a characterization of the drug is there, and accordingly, when the drug is administered into the body of the model organism, we need to focus on these characteristic parameters and keep observing the behavior of that particular organism or model organism in the laboratory, right, after administration of a drug. Now, let's see what are the principles on the use of animals. You cannot use any animal as a model organism for drug testing. No, you need to take the permission of the Animal Ethical Committee. Animal Ethical Committee is a committee which is working for the well-being as well as maintenance of the rearing animals or animals, natural animals, right? So, Animal Ethical Committee is there, or like that, number of different types of organizations are also there which are serving for the animals, which are protecting them, right? So, certain principles have put forth by them. Let's see what are the principles. All activities involving animal must conduct strictly in accordance with the present legislation. Certain kind of laws are put forth regarding the use of animals for the research purpose. And if someone is using that animal for the research purpose, the person has to follow the rules and regulation of the said committee. Alternative to the animal experiment must be used whenever possible. If it is possible to be tested on the fungi, bacteria, insect, like that, then you should go for that and then and only. Or if it is not possible, then and then only you should use the animals for the drug testing. Even transgenic animals may be used for testing experiments when this model is justified, right? When you have characterized your model, when you have characterized your candidate medicine, and you can use the transgenic model for the testing. Even animal bred specifically for experimental purposes must be used unless special conditions are in evidence, right? So, whatever young ones are born that can be used for the experiment under special conditions. If you want to, or if some drug is need to be tested on the newborn. So, at that time also, that animal newborn can be selected for testing a particular drug. Housing, husbandry, and transportation of these animals must be minimum. So, these animals do not, or they should not suffer from any kind of a diseases. The rearing house, animal rearing house must be clean. It must be well ventilated. It must be well maintained so that the animals will be healthy. They will not suffer from any kind of a diseases. Even the rearing house and transportation of these animals must be minimum. Transportation should be minimized. Rearing should be proper. Animal husbandry, that is said to be. So, that these rearing houses must meet international standards. Even housing condition must taken into consideration. Proper sanitation must be there, ventilation must be there, cleanliness, even proper feed is given to them, medicines, vaccination to the rearing animals must be on time. So and then only these animals will be in healthy conditions. Then housing, husbandry and care of the animal must be undertaken by person having received adequate and relevant education. So these are certain principles which need to be followed by a person who is going to continue with a animal rearing house. All right. Now, health control should be supervised by a veterinary officer. Health control of a particular experimental animal is need to be supervised. It need to be observed by the animal husband, or you can say animal supervisor, or you can say veterinary doctor. Then transportation of the animals must be as considered as possible, taking into consideration the special need for a particular animal species in question. Right? So, if this animal is need to be transported to another city for the experiment, then and then only, whether it is important, whether it is necessary, then and then only it can be allowed to transport. All precautions must be taken to reduce suffering and distress. The animal, model animals which are used, they should not suffer much for the distress. They should not suffer much for the stress. So, that's why the transportation is normally avoided. Right? So, procedures for monitoring and evaluation of the well-being of the animals as well as the treatment must be implemented. Procedures for monitoring, evaluation of a well-being of an animal as well as a treatment must be implemented. Records must be kept updated on the type of experiment, animal species used and number of animals used in accordance with the authorities. Right? For every experiment, there is specific kind of a procedure we have followed. Right? The procedure is need to be recorded. Its record is need to be maintained. Animal species, which animal we have used? What is the age of that animal? Right? What are the body characteristics? Right? Then what is the weight? What is height? Means like that. All the physiological important things that need to be noted. Even number of animals used for that experiment is need to be recorded. And then only we can get some kind of a firm output through the result. So, record, maintaining record is again very important phenomenon. Now, dear students, we have seen the concept of a model organism, why model organisms are required for the pharmaceutical industry to be tested or for the testing. Then how the drug is discovered, how it is characterized and how it can be tested on the animals that we have seen. Now let's see the